Hey guys, it is Sunday, February 9th, 2020, 12:35 in the afternoon. Been a while since I've updated. Let's remedy that. This is my little Texas rat snake. And he or she is giving me a little bit of trouble. Been regurgitating about every other meal, but then sometimes she will take a small pinky aggressively and pass it. She ate Thursday and she had poop this morning, so I'm really pulling for her. She lost some weight over the winter, so I'm hoping that her appetite picks up and she becomes healthy. She's still very active. Her eyes are bright, tongue flicks. She's inquisitive and active, as you can see. I named her Rodeo, being a Texas rat. So I'm really pulling for this little one. Take a look at Jane next. She is my normal corn. And there's something about her that I just really love. Maybe because she doesn't have any bright, vivid colors or bold black borders. And she's not growing as fast as some of my previous corns, so her genetics may have her stay on the smaller side, maybe max out at 3 feet. In the past, I've had Okeetis that were about 4.5. So she or he may stay on the smaller side. I did cut back a little bit on feeding. Wow, she's really squeezing. Surprising how strong she is. She started getting a little bit of what they call hips for a corn snake. So I'm not feeding her as large of mice. I'm going back to hoppers. She can take a small adult. But she's a very well-tempered snake. Although admittedly, I don't handle my snakes as much as I should. But that's Jane. We'll move on to my next one. And here's Georgia, my black milk, who is almost solid black, still retaining some coloring on her sides, getting some good size on her as well. What a beautiful, beautiful snake. And as I've said previously, just such a joy to hold. And once again, she's skittish because I don't hold them as much as I should. But still, no nervous striking or aggressive tendencies at all. Just a little nervous. So she is doing fabulous. And I think she's right at about 3 feet right now. Not a bad replacement if you can't get an Eastern Indigo. Look at that shine. We'll put her back. And here's Lou, my New Mexico bull snake. Rattling her tail. And even though she's nervous, she really doesn't strike. In fact, she hasn't struck at me since I first got her. And what a contrast in colors between her and the milk snake. I love how she's so black at her tail, as opposed to the tans and grays everywhere else. I love that bull snake head. And she as well, what a sound. She's right at 3 feet too. So I expect her and the black milk to maybe double in size or close to that. All right, we'll get her back and take a look at my leopard gecko. So this is Echo. He's a 2 to 2.5 year old, I believe. And I bought off Craigslist. And he is full of such personality. He knows when it's feeding time because I get the tongs out and go to a certain side of his cage. So compared to the snakes, he is just so smart. Healthy fat tail. And he's the reason I started my Dubia colony, which is doing well. Oh, I've got a couple of litters of babies in that colony. Hopefully we'll have some more soon. So I am starting to feed them off. He eats about every other day, maybe 3 to 4 dubias. I just don't want to feed off my colony before they really have time to get established. What a fantastic little guy. All right, I'm gonna let him go back to sleep. And here is my latest addition. Little crested gecko born this past November. So November, December, January, February, about 3 months old. 2.5 maybe. I just upgraded the enclosure. And don't let all that bother you. That's all underneath that. That's just hot glue. It's the feeding station. I've got some dry and wet food with water suspended. Hide there. And I handle this little one every once in a while, but mainly I'm leaving it alone for a while. Down beneath here, there's a coconut hide. And you can see some of the ventilation I have. So let's say I've got a pretty decent zoo for the next 15 to 20 years. That's an update on my animals, and we will see you next time.